You know, more often than not, when I get to actually meet you folks in person, like at events and stuff, almost always the first thing that I get told is, "Wow, you're a lot taller than I thought." Like, does the camera actually misrepresent my height that much? Anyway, that's completely unrelated to this video, but today's video is gonna be very much a sort of relaxed, sort of chill video, let's say. Feel free to just tab out and leave it in the background because I'm just gonna be rambling and rambling and rambling about G. So I already filmed this video once before, I think last week when I was first trying to get it done, but it was such a sad mood, and I kept sort of being so sappy about it. And while I am sad, and it is sort of a sad topic for me, I felt like it's not really like I shouldn't be pushing that mood too much, so I decided to redo it again. And so that's why I'm advertising, and so that's why I'm saying, you know, feel free to tab out and just listen in the background because I'm just gonna be rambling about things in the last 3 years of Vanguard. So I'm gonna be talking about G in the sense of the anime and the game, as well as personal factors. So the first two are sort of more generic, that like things that you probably relate to or don't relate to, or like, you know, things that you might agree with or disagree with. Whereas the last one is sort of just like my own life and like what G meant to me personally, and sort of like unrelated to the game, or, you know, unrelated to like these like specific topics, but more just like what it means to me and what it did to me. So I'm gonna begin with the anime. So Vanguard G's anime started off kind of slow. I still remember when the first episode aired. I think it was a German regionals that we were at with, you know, my friends, and I remember we were waking up for day two, I think. So like for me, that was like the buddy fight day, and like Nelson, one of my teammates, that for them that was the Weiss Schwartz day. And I remember we were waking up, and the first episode of G went up, and then we watched it in bed, and then we like ran to each other's rooms. We were like, "Dude, did you see? Like, oh my god, look at all these like special effects, and like, oh my god, the soundtrack and everything." And to us, like, it was really, really cool. And then it kind of started falling off because the first season didn't really show the full fights for a while, and like they kept like skipping around, and it felt more like I'm watching a Fate series than I'm watching a card game anime. So it was sort of strange at first. But like I grew to like the cast, you know, throughout the thing. A lot of them felt a bit one-dimensional for a while, and then, you know, they introduced the, you know, sort of the enemies, or like the bad guys, you know, with Kanzaki and stuff. And, you know, that was an interesting thing, but not that much. Like, I think first season was the worst thing about the anime. But then I think it kicked into high gear, and then it was going the whole time. So like both Gears Crisis and Strike Gate were really cool, and like Strike Gates, I think it was Strike Gates, but like the second Mamoru Miya no opening, Shout, is like one of my favorites of the franchise. So like it's really good opening, and like the song and the visuals are really nice. So I really like Strike Gate and Gears Crisis, because I think there we saw these turns in characters, like Shion changed completely, and we saw a lot of character growth. And then like for the rest of the team, there was also some, but not, you know, to a massive extent. I know that the Crono versus Ryuzu final fight is like one of people's favorites. I liked it a lot too. I don't think it's my favorite from the series. It's not my favorite fight, at least, but it's like it's a really good one. And then when G Next hits, that's my favorite one. That's like my second favorite, probably, season of Vanguard in general. Like, it was really fun. It had this like more relaxed sort of school atmosphere. It broke up the, you know, Tri-3 and like the main teams, and, you know, put them into these different, you know, teams with like the Striders and Haima Flowers and Fukuhara Hai, and like those teams were a lot more fun. Like, I think Striders was alright. They had Kazuma, which was a new face, which was fun to see. Then Haima Flowers had the whole, you know, Tokoha plot going on with Miguel. And then finally, Fukuhara obviously had basically the best cast of characters with my. Well, like, Shion is like one of my favorites, but like Henry and Rin obviously are basically my favorites from G. So it had interesting plot lines, and it sort of had an interesting just rhythm going about it. The soundtrack was amazing, Henry's character was amazing. Like, G Next onwards, the soundtrack was just god tier, and it was really enjoyable. And like, one of my favorite fights in, you know, G as a whole was Henry versus Verno. So, like, I don't know why, I just really enjoyed that fight. Like, every fight that Henry was in, I really enjoyed, but especially that one had just, oh, it had such a nice vibe to it. Like, I really enjoyed it. And so it was just a cool season to me. And then GZ was, I would say, you know, it started to dip a bit. It still had interesting things, and like the apostles were, they were all right, but I think like they were rushed, and like they didn't really expand on the characters that much. Like, they legit had Yukarin voice Gridor for like two episodes or something, so it's kind of like not exactly the best. And then like Astiel didn't really live up to that much either, so it was sort of, you know, kind of this iffy season, but for me, I like GZ because I was living in Japan at that time. So for me, like, the memory of like waking up on a Sunday to watch GZ on the TV was a really cool one, because like that's when we saw a lot of skills, like Megiddo was shown for the first time, Valios for the first time on the anime. So for me, that was cool to see like these skills, you know, waking up in the morning in Japan and seeing it before everybody else in the world. So that was always like a positive memory for me. But the most important part about the anime for me is the cast. Now, I like the cast of the original too, you know, there's a lot of talented voice actors, and you know, they also love the game, like the main, you know, the Q4 voice actors, you know, they cried at the end of their, like, when the original series ended and everything, like, to them it's also something they're attached to. But I never felt something from them, which I felt very hard from the G cast, which is love for the game. So it's not love for the series, not showing love to the anime just because you're being paid to do so. Like, Ishii Mark, so Chrono's voice actor, Nishi Kensuke, which is Henry's voice actor, and Batori Shogo, who is Kazuma's voice actor, all the three of them, they're like the best part of G to me, because the three of them have actual, like, they really enjoy the game and they play it all the time. Like, they talked about this like in events or on the radio or on Twitter, where they go to like Nishi-san's house and like for like a weekend and just play Vanguard for the whole weekend. Or like, you know, there's like, they upload photos where they just like go around together enjoying things, or like in the hotel rooms they play on like the beds, and that's like things that we do, you know, like we play Vanguard on hotel beds, like I've done that many times. And so it's cool to see these voice actors so like into the game and enjoying it. You know, they go to like card shops, like, you know, greet people and whatnot, and so they actually really enjoy the game. So I really appreciate the fact that like they showed care for Vanguard, not because they're being paid for as voice actors, but because they genuinely enjoy the game. And especially with Ishii Mark, I had a lot of chances to meet him. Like, I saw him in Daivangasai in Osaka for the first time, and then I ran into him at a train station once, which was random but really cool. And then when I was commentating, he was also on stage, but sadly our times sort of didn't match, so I didn't get to speak to him backstage or anything. And then in WGP Tokyo, I also saw him. So, like, I got to see him a lot of times, as well as a lot of the other characters, and, like, I mean, the cast. So, like, Aiba Aina, Tokoha's voice actress, she's, like, really cool. She has this sort of, like, you know, tough vibe to her, but she's also really funny, and, like, she enjoys her job. You know, she might not be, like, that passionate about Vanguard, but she enjoys, like, the overall atmosphere of, you know, the community, I suppose. So, I really like that about her. And then, like, to me, Nishi-san, Henry's voice actor, is like one of my favorite members of the cast, because he really, really does enjoy Vanguard, and like, you know, to him this means a lot. Like, he's replied to me on Twitter in English even, so it's like really incredible. And same with Kazuma's voice actor, Batori Shogo, he's also replied to me in English, you know, after I went to some event and saw them. And then, you know, things like that actually do mean a lot, because they stick to you. And so seeing the cast being so connected with the community honestly leaves a better impression than, you know, the original cast, which sort of didn't really do that, and I don't expect them to do that in the reboot either. So that's basically it for the anime parts. TLDR is just the cast that I really like, and that's who made G more memorable to me in, like, in general. And then in terms of the game, I think it started off all right. Like, G had this interesting start where we got a lot of like the Great Three Legions, like Daikaiser and stuff, and then like Legion was sort of finishing and into G, and it's sort of like intertwining period. And then I think after BT04 is when the G format sort of defined itself, and like then like Next Stage was printed, and then, you know, like, and then after GBT05 it's like we had Time Leap, we had all these things, and then GBT06 we got Night Rose, and then G was its own thing. And that's one thing that I really like on the topic of Night Rose, is that G as a game, you know, part of the game, it gave a lot of clans this proper identity that they didn't really have. Like, for example, Nova Grappler has always been sort of jumping between these sort of like avatar units. It's like first it's a Shura Kaiser, then it's Perfect Riser, then it's Ethics Buster, and then it's sort of like just jumping between these like main units all the time. And G is just like Victor, just here's Victor. And like the whole thing was just Victor, and it's great because Nova, like the face of Nova Grappler is now Victor to us, and that's really cool. Same with Angel Feather. Like, before, who did you associate Angel Feather with? Like, one of the many units? Celestials as an archetype? No, it's like, you just had these like random ones that just kept jumping around, but now it's just Gavriel. And, you know, I really like that. So it's like, for Grand Blue as well, like, there was, like, Gokaitis and Baskirk, but Night Rose, just, like, Night Rose, Grand Blue, that's it. And so that really defined clans to me in G, and that's what I really like about G over the original, because it really just sort of gave clans an identity, and especially clans that didn't have one before, like Murakumo with Yasuya and stuff like that, or especially Nobutama with Shirame. But I do acknowledge that G did have some problems. Like, to me, what I loved about G is, as a game itself, is that it was the most complex. You know, there's a lot of complex combos and things with G-guards and, like, you know, resolution where it's like turn player priority actually matters in how a skill might resolve. And so there's a lot of these cool, interesting combos. Like, Time Leap, as much as people hate it, was a complicated deck to play and had a lot of intrinsic combos that were really cool. Same with Night Rose. Like, there were some interactions that you had to know for Night Rose to be able to pilot it correctly. And so that made G really fun for me, especially because as a commentator, I love to watch G decks, especially Night Rose. That's like my favorite deck to watch ever, because it's so fun to see the combos just roll out and good players maximizing the potential of those combos. So for me, that part of G is really important in that it made the game very sort of like complex, but I do admit that there are a lot of bad things about, you know, G's card game part as well. The ZR fiasco was unnecessary, like those prices should not have existed. The entry price into the game as well became just unreasonable, and I think if it kept on going like this, Vanguard would die, because I don't think you can sustain a card game if you keep just adding to the price. So I think the reboot was a very smart decision, because it allows people to build decks for like 150, you know, for like a proper card game budget, rather than like spending 300 bucks on a deck that isn't even meta. You know, like that's what G got to, and it's kind of ridiculous. And I do obviously admit that there was power creep. You know, I think that's pretty well known with everyone. They did power creep sets a lot. I think until GBT, I want to say 10, but maybe 11? Like the set where ZTBs finally became good enough to replace Time Leap. That's the set, and like the battle system, like, I think that's GBT 11, if I'm not mistaken, or 12. I think 11. But basically that set is when power creep just went out of control, and like now I sort of understand that the reason why they did the power creep is because they wanted to sort of like make sure that those clans that receive that power creep will stay strong going into the reboots, that like those cards will last in premium. But then it's like Vanquisher, I really like the deck, but it really doesn't compete with anything that came out in the last two sets. So it's like, it's not exactly the most fair power creep either. So it's like you either creep them all to the same level, or you don't creep them at all. And so I'm not sure what they were trying to do with that. No, I mean, like, I think they were trying to just like keep it so that like they're still strong in premium, and that these cards will not be outshone by, you know, the new reboot cards for a while. But we'll see how that actually ends up being. And, you know, for me, G in general was the most fun I've had with Vanguard, despite the fact that I didn't have a locals, because my locals here died in basically Legion era, and then after that we had like two people in my shop. So with the reboot, I'm going to be trying to revive that locals and trying to like get people to try it out with a caravan and stuff like that. I'll have a video on that later on, but you know, I'm going to try to revive my locals in the community here in Luxembourg, because I really want to enjoy playing Vanguard locally again. But you know, even though I wasn't able to play, you know, G physically that much, I relied on online play a lot, or like, you know, just playing with friends when they come over, or I go over to them, you know, it still was a really enjoyable time, and so I'm going to always remember it very dearly. And now the personal part. I'm going to try to not get too touchy-feely with this, but I'll do my best. So I've been playing Vanguard since 2011, or like the end of 2011, but, you know, and at that time we did have a locals, a pretty active one at that, a lot of good players in my locals too. So we had tournaments like every 2 weeks, sometimes even every week. We had tournaments with like special rules, or like a kind of like a circuit series for like where a whole month, like there's a tournament going on and you just like play your games out throughout the course of a tournament. So I had a lot of chances to play Vanguard during the original series, and like I would go after school every day to the card shop and we'd play until like 7 and then go get dinner, you know. So I have a lot of positive memories with that, and as I mentioned with G, I didn't have those locals anymore because I was also moving around a lot, and then, you know, when I came back, there was basically nobody left, everybody moved to Yu-Gi-Oh! Again, so that was sort of a problem, but me having the locals doesn't necessarily mean that was my biggest enjoyment of Vanguard ever, because to me, G was when I found my role, or sort of my purpose in the community. Because I started making videos towards the end of the originals, like in Legion era. Well, I was making videos a long time ago, but I sort of started properly, consistently making videos at the end of the Legion era. And then, you know, I started to, you know, kick off a little bit. But, like, if Gear Chronicle didn't exist, if I didn't get that random idea to, like, film the How to Play Gear Chronicle video from just, like, the two trial decks I got, I don't know if I would even be here anymore, because, like, that one video skyrocketed my, you know, popularity, I guess, in the community, like, a lot. And then, you know, from the How to Play series, it sort of started growing, and then I started sort of doing more diverse content, like what I do now. You know, I still enjoy making the occasional meme video, I just don't really have, like, sometimes I don't have the energy for it, or sometimes I feel like I'm not in the right mood for it, or like if I do when I'm in this mood, it might not be as funny compared to like if I did it when I'm in a good mood. So it's sort of like, you know, this sort of always like swaying emotions, I guess. That sounds kind of weird, but so because of that, it was sort of like G was really important, because that's when I became a proper YouTuber, I want to say. Like, this is when I found my true calling in the community. Like, I love making videos, I love talking to people and finding out new things that I can convert into videos, and you know, that's my role in the community now. Like, if it wasn't for YouTube, I might not be playing Vanguard, and like, this led to a lot of things. Like, I met a lot of amazing people throughout all this time, and like, in Japan, you know, I even ran into some people that knew who I am, and that was like really incredible. And you know, speaking of Japan, that's also one of the reasons why I think of G very positively, because when I was in Japan, I could go to local tournaments every single day. And you know, obviously that was in G format, and because of that, you know, I always have this positive memory of like, wow, it was so nice playing Vanguard back in Japan, like every single day, tournaments and everything. So, you know, it comes back to that whole like, because it's a positive memory, I remember it well. So it's sort of that thing. So, you know, coming back to the whole YouTube thing, like, if it wasn't for YouTube, I might not even be playing the game anymore, because that's how important it is to me, and I think you guys know that pretty well as well. But, you know, from YouTube, the one thing that it led to, which is still my greatest achievement throughout my time on this planet, basically, is the commentary. Like, that would not have been possible without my presence on YouTube, I think. And I think that, like, it's like, because it happened at the end of G, essentially, it makes it even more memorable. And, like, just the feeling of sitting there on the grand stage and commentating these games, like, talking about my favorite thing in the world in front of all these people is just such an amazing memory that, like, you know, I would like to do it again for the reboot, you know, hoping that I maybe get invited or something again. You know, that would be nice, but even if I don't, like, the commentary is by far one of my greatest memories ever, one of the greatest achievements I have in my life, honestly, and so that's why, like, I'm always gonna remember it really well, because it's attached to G. So, you know, at the end of the day, I really enjoyed what G gave us. These last 3 years were really, really fun, you know, with the anime and the game and all these personal factors. They led to me growing as a person very much, and so I'm really thankful for that. There were some amazing people that I've met throughout this time, and I don't think I would have met them, you know, if it wasn't for G, essentially, and so I'm always gonna remember it positively. I know it was a shaky ride, a lot of people quit the game, you know, there were quite a few people starting it too, but, you know, the general player base did decline, you know, we have to admit that, I think, you know, at least that's what it seems like. But, you know, it's looking better for the future, a lot of people are coming back, a lot of people are getting into the game, and I'm gonna be doing my best to grow the game in my local area as well, because I do not want this game dying, I want it to keep on going. You know, it's always healthy in Japan, it's always doing well in Japan, but I want it to do well all over the world. So I'm glad that Bushiroad's focusing more on the world, and I'm gonna be doing my best as well. So that's it for this touchy-feely video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I don't normally do a lot of these things, but I felt like I needed to do some kind of like closure video to G, or at least like one of my final closure videos, because there's like one more thing I want to do that's related to G ending that I need to make sure I do sometime soon. But for now, this is like the big one that I wanted to do. So it's a little bit long, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. So that's going to be it for me today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Do let me know your memories of G, whether they're good or bad or anything, you know, whether it's anime related or game related or something that happened in your life. Do let me know, because, you know, I've shared a lot with you guys, so I'd like to hear the same back. So on that topic, that's going to be it for me today. Don't forget to check out the social media in the description, as well as join the Discord channel and hit the bell button if you haven't already. I just sort of switch the way the outro usually goes, but never mind. But on that note, that's gonna be it for me today. I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.